I have a small question regarding the phase two that you are. I have a second regarding the phase two.
Yeah.
According to my knowledge, something similar to your clinical test, phase two, a group against a placebo, was conducted in Shatter Institute in Sacramento by Dr. Michael Chez. If you know his work, because...
Oh, I know that work,
Because his conclusion was that these treatments work.
No,
for
actually...
For autism?
No. Okay. I reviewed that paper. I'm an editor on that journal. I know the final version of that paper.
Okay.
Which is not published yet, is coming out. Okay.
I saw the YouTube clip that the movie that
no,
he's
I'm telling
talking.
You. Okay. Okay. He did not have enough data to say it worked or not.
Yeah, it was
he
very small
not,
group.
He yes. did not have statistical significance to his endpoint.
Okay.
He played around with how he mixed up the kids in groups, and he still didn't get statistical significance. So there is a trend similar to what we saw that maybe it's beneficial.
If I may, I know that some institute in Panama and Thailand, and even in India, they are performing some kind of stem cell treatment. I'm not sure whether it's cord blood or something else. And they report, like what you said, that it affects the...
Yeah, so there. I don't know everything that every group is doing, but the group in Panama is using what they call an MSC, which is a cell from cord tissue, actually. But they make it, they say, from cord blood, which you can't do.
Okay.
And they are infusing just random cord blood to kids with autism, and they are saying it works. And I'm not disputing that, but they haven't done any kind of trial. They just take your money and infuse your child, and if it works, that's good for you.
You believe it's not as effective as the... On cord blood
so
or the similar.
I don't know. So that's I didn't put those slides in, but we are making MSCs from cord tissue. We are testing them in children with autism. They have an advantage of being able to be given more than one time. Mm-hmm. Somebody asked me that at the beginning, and you can give from the same donor multiple doses. So we are testing that in kids with autism, but we are manufacturing it in a safe way, where we know the cells are reliable and will perform, and if they're gonna have benefit, they will. So I think in the next few years, there'll be answers. I don't know what they're doing in India. There's some stuff in Mexico, there's some stuff in Korea. The one thing I would say is don't let anybody give your kids cells you don't know what they are. Let anybody give cells where you don't know that the donor was tested for hepatitis, HIV, because your kid could get hepatitis or HIV. And don't let anybody put cells in your kid's brain or spinal fluid that you don't know were purified, because that can cause tumors, death, really bad things. And I know you want to help your kids, but if I were you, but I knew what I know as me, I would not do those things. And there are very scary reports out there of bad things happening because people didn't manufacture the cells right. They didn't collect them right or make them right or test the donor or keep them sterile, and then your child can end up with being much worse than they are now.
Okay, so thank you.